Welcome to a comprehensive video on how to use the features of a Matterport virtual tour. All current features are covered in addition to general usage tips. Matterport virtual tours are powerful marketing tools that Barnes Creative Studios produces for residential real estate, commercial real estate, hospitality, and more. The paramount difference in Matterport virtual tours versus fisheye 360 images is that you are creating assets using data and not simply a photograph. This gives you tons of advantages and future-proofs your media. The 360 image is greatly limited, is clunky, does not give an ability to walk the space, and cannot be converted to a virtual reality experience. All in all, if you purchase 360 photographs, you are selling yourself very short compared to the value and robustness of a Matterport virtual tour. There are many amazing features with tons of value. If you have not used Matterport virtual tours before, it might take you a minute to navigate all of the great options, which is why I have produced this video to help you get a quick overview. What you are looking at here is the embedded Matterport virtual tour that is easily embedded to any website with a simple embed code like you would see for a YouTube video. Let's have a look around the screen. In the top left is the info field that shows the title of your Matterport virtual tour. You can click more to see some more information if it was created, and also the verified address if it was added and verified. If a tour has a verified address, it will automatically show up on a realtor.com listing, among other sites. You can also switch off the Mattertag content here if you did not want it on your screen for any reason. You can click these two arrows to get rid of the box. At the bottom, you see the highlight reel, which can be created with any view from the entire Matterport virtual tour and can also include 360 images that are not part of the Matterport virtual tour. These 360 images are captured as an image and not as virtual tour data. These 360 images look very similar to the actual Matterport virtual tour, but they are independent and will only show up in a highlight reel. These locations could include the exterior of a house, a large attached space that you simply wanted to highlight but did not want to be part of the tour, or could even be something nowhere near your location. We will discuss the highlight reel more later. For now, I can simply click the down arrow to hide it. The next set of controls is to start the guided tour, also known as the highlight reel. We will dive into this in just a few minutes. To the right of the guided tour controls is the dollhouse icon, which will load the dollhouse view if there is one created. You do have the option not to display a dollhouse. Clicking this icon will also give you an option to see the floor plan if it was created. When you first click the dollhouse icon, the dollhouse will pop up and you can either use your desktop arrows or mouse to pull it any direction you would like. On a mobile device, you would simply touch the screen and pull it whatever direction you would like. While in the dollhouse mode, you could click or tap anywhere inside the dollhouse to jump inside to that specific location. If a floor plan was created, you can click the floor plan to see it. If labels were produced, they will be displayed when viewing in floor plan mode. Same as in dollhouse mode, you could click or tap anywhere inside the dollhouse to jump inside to that specific location. Jumping to the other side of the screen of this Matterport virtual tour, there are icons which launch more features. The icon which looks like a mask is applicable when viewing on a phone. It will only be there if a virtual reality version of your Matterport virtual tour has been produced. Touching this logo will launch the tour in VR mode, and you will need virtual reality goggles to view it. You will also need to download the free Matterport VR app for your device. If sharing has been enabled for your Matterport virtual tour, then you will see this universally recognized share icon. Clicking it will give a user options to share through to Facebook, Twitter, email, or via a dedicated link. The next icon is to view the Matterport virtual tour in full screen mode, which is only applicable on larger desktop screens. On mobile devices, full screen is default. Above the full screen icon are plus and minus signs for zooming in and zooming out. This also is only available on desktop. On mobile, you would pinch in or out to zoom. Click anywhere on the screen to jump down into the virtual tour. I will click this bullseye, and that will set me down inside at the point on the tour that I have set as the default starting point. You can grab the screen with your mouse and set it to whatever viewing angle you prefer. You can walk around the space in a few different ways. You can click or tap the screen, or you can use your arrows on a desktop to face left and right and move forward and backwards. The white circles on the floor are points where the camera collected data. You could click directly on one if you wanted to see the space from that perspective. Context can be added anywhere along the Matterport virtual tour in a myriad of ways. Mattertags are blue and white circles that can be attached anywhere throughout the space. You can make them as simple as only text, or you could get elaborate with video, maps, images, or anything you want from the over 400 options that can be embedded. If you hover over this first example, you will see that I have embedded a video that will autoplay when you hover over it and stop when you remove it. Inside the master bedroom, you can see another example. That has live chat with a link and a feature image that we made for simply display purposes. If you click on the image, it will open up and fully display. If you click the link, it will open up the web page in another window. Looking back towards the front door, you will also see a matter tag. This one has an option to view more floor plans available at this property. Same as the previous matter tag, you can click to open the image and also to visit the website. Best practice is to not overdo it with these contextual bubbles, as it can be overwhelming. The bigger the space, the more you can get away with. Now to the guided highlight reel, which will only exist if it was created. Highlights are chosen and can be found by clicking the up arrow in the bottom left corner of the screen. You can scroll through and jump to any highlight of the tour by clicking on the thumbnail. If you click the play button, the guided tour will start to play, similar to a video experience. At any point during the guided tour, you can just grab the screen and take over and walk the space at your leisure. You can also click play to resume and click the right and left arrows to go back or move ahead on the guided tour. I will leave you with a few tricks that could come in handy. If you press the letter U, you will get a URL that you can use to get back to this exact spot on the Matterport virtual tour. This could be handy if you want to send a specific starting point for someone, or also if you wanted to point out still images you would like me to grab for you. Simply copy and paste the URL and email away. Another tip is that you can press P to turn the white circles on the floor on and off. You can also speed up or slow down the moves on the tour. I hope this Matterport virtual tour info is helpful to you. You can reach us anytime at barnescreativestudios.com for information on creating a Matterport virtual tour.